Hey guys, welcome to another draw and design tutorial. In this video we will learn 10 easy steps to model a Revit family along with three types and make a table just like the one you are seeing on the screen. But first I ask you to please subscribe to my channel, it will help me out a lot. And also turn on the notification so you don't miss my future videos. In first step, we will choose a template. We will start with a new family and select a furniture template from the list as we are going to make a table. In second step, we will modify our interface a bit. We will close all other sheets, then set up the reference level window and front view window by clicking the tile window button in the view tab. In third step, we will add reference planes in reference level window. We will add 3 layers of reference plane on all 4 sides with the gap of 4 inches between each of them. During adding the reference planes, make sure all of them intersect the perpendicular ones on all 4 corners, because the intersection point will guide us better in building the geometry. You can use copy and mirror commands during the process, which will make it much more easier. Or you can just draw all of them. The most outer layer defines the boundary of the table, while 2 inner layers work as the guide for legs position. Next, we will add reference planes in the front view window. We need to add 2 reference planes for table shelf and 2 reference planes for table top. After this, you can adjust the distance between them manually. In fourth step, we will add dimensions. We will select the Align Dimension tool and first we will mark the inner layer with the dimensions. Then click EQ to make them equal. Then we will add dimensions for outer layer and make them constant by clicking the lock icon. Make sure to make the dimensions for all the reference planes. Now mark the aligned dimension between outermost layers of reference planes. Now go to front view and mark the aligned dimension. First add dimension from base to top. Then add dimension for thickness of top and shelf. Also add dimension from base to shelf. In fifth step, we will make the parameters. Go to reference level window and select length dimension and click on create parameter in label dimension panel. Then write the name of parameter in dialog box and click OK. Now make the parameter for width and height also using the same procedure. Whenever I model a family, I flex it often to make sure that the model is not breaking apart. To flex this model, change the dimension of length, width, and height parameters. If the model changed dynamically, it means it is not broken. After this, select the top reference plane in front view and rename it as top. And then select the shelf reference plane and rename it as shelf. In sixth step, we will build the geometry. Go to Create tab, select Set Work Plane command. In the dialog box, set top reference plane and click OK. Now go to Form panel, select Solid Extrusion, then take Arc tool from Draw panel and start drawing the geometry for tabletop. After drawing the geometry, close the extrusion command and go to front view. Then drag the extrusion from arrow shape grip, attach to reference plane and lock them. Then flex the model by changing dimensions to make sure everything works correctly. Again, go to Create tab and select Solid Extrusion Form from Form panel. Then select Rectangle tool from Draw panel and start making legs one by one on each corner. Make sure you lock them with all four sides reference planes. Then close the extrusion command and go to front view. Select the legs extrusion, then drag from the middle grip and attach one grip to reference plane and lock it. And other grip to tabletop and also lock it. Again, flex the model and change the dimensions to make sure it works correctly. Again, go to Create tab and select Set Work Plane command. This time select the shelf reference plane and click OK. Now go to Form panel and select Solid Extrusion. Select the Pick Line tool from Draw panel with an offset of 4 inch and start drawing the geometry for table. Click on the inner edge of table boundary and make shelf boundary. Now zoom into one corner and make corners joined with legs using line tool and trim extend tool. Now do the same for other three corners. Now go to front view and drag the shelf extrusion from blue grip and attach to designated reference planes. In seventh step, we will flex the model. It is the absolute and most important part in the family editor. Now flex is the Revit term for tested out to make sure it is not broken. Check every component of table changes dynamically while changing the dimensions. In eighth step, we will add some family types. Switch to 3D view, go to Create tab, Properties panel, and click on Family Type button. This will open up the Family Type dialog box. Now click on New Type button and another box will pop up. Write the name of family type and click OK. Now change the dimensions in parameter value and click OK. Add some more families and then close the family type command. In ninth step, we will add materials on our model. Select any family component and go to Properties panel, Materials and Finishes section, and click on this button. This will open the material browser. Now apply the desired material to component and repeat this for all family components. In the last step, we will load this family into our project. So quickly make a new project and then return to family editor. Click on load into project button and this will load the family into level 1 sheet. Then add all family types into project. And that's it, our family modeling with types and applied material loaded successfully into our project. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please click like button, give your suggestions in comment section and share the video with others. Thanks for watching the video. See you in the next one.